Good afternoon, this is Vishnuvardhan, Assistant Professor from the Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering of St. Martin's Engineering College. Today I am going to discuss about the rotating magnetic field. Rotating magnetic field. This rotating magnetic field will be exist in the induction motors. We know that coming into the DC motors, there will be, for example, I am taking two poles for the DC motor. There is north pole and south pole. The magnetic field will be takes place in between north pole and south pole. The magnetic lines will be in the linear, that is in straight line side. But while coming into the rotating magnetic field, the magnetic field will be rotated. The magnetic field will be rotated. Actually, for the induction motor, we give the three phase supply. The three-phase supply, where we are giving the three-phase supply, the magnetic field will be rotated. How the magnetic field will be rotated? Let us see. Let us take a stator. Let us take a stator of the induction motor. And for this stator, I am taking three windings. Each and every winding, single turn winding I am taking. For that, every turn consists of two conductors, that is R, R dash, and Y, Y dash, and B, B dash. These three conductors are placed in 120 degrees apart, like from R to Y, there will be 120 degrees. And from Y to B, there will be 120 degrees apart we are placing. How it will be? Let us see in the diagram. See, let us say this is the R phase winding, R and R dash. And let us say this is Y and Y dash and Y. And this is B and B dash winding. Means these three windings were connected in, for example, if you are connected in star connection, then what will happen in middle point, this middle junction we will indicate this by N, that is neutral point. It means the junction point is the combination of Y, R dash, Y dash and B dash. It means the second end side of these three windings were connected at one point. So we make it as star connection. And for this winding, if you are giving the supply, that is three phase supply, that is R phase is connected to R phase winding, R winding, and Y phase is connected to Y winding, and D phase is connected to B winding. Now, whenever a current serves, see, this is a three phase supply. This is the three phase supply, that is AC supply. Three phase AC supply we are giving to the stator of the induction motor. Then what will happen? See, whenever we are giving the three phase supply, for example, this at this condition, at this instant, the R phase is 0. The R phase current is 0. Let us take the maximum. Let us start from here. That is at from R phase is at maximum. That is maximum. The peak value. Peak value. So that this R phase I am taking maximum use. Let us take this peak value is 10 amperes, for example. For example. And this point is not maximum. Means the junction point, the touching point, this is Y phase and B phase, touching point is not maximum. This group could be less than 10 amperes. So let us take this is at 5 amperes for our 10 amperes. See, whenever I am giving a supply, the R phase value is maximum, that is in positive peak. So that's why the current will enter into R phase, that is 10 amperes, for example, I am taking. And when coming into the B phase, Y phase and D phase, those are in negative peak. Negative peak and not maximum. Then for our current, I am taking 5 amperes. Means current is negative, means current is coming out. So that's why I am indicating it as 5 amperes minus 5 amperes. And here also I am indicating minus 5 amperes. It means as per the case here, the current entering into the junction, which must be equal to the sum of the currents leaving from the junction. So that's why the current entering is 10 amperes. The current entering into this is 10 amperes. And current is leaving from this is 5 amperes time is here also. So this is satisfactory case. Now we are coming into the state of this. How it will be connected? Let us see. For R phase, we are giving R phase supply, that is amperes. And we have to see here, we have to observe here, R dash, Y dash, and B dash is connected at one point. So it means we have to connect here also. Y dash, R dash, and B dash. These three we have to connect like this. And we have to see that the current entering into R and leaving from R dash. Current entering means we have to indicate it by something that cross. I am indicating it by cross, the current entering point. And current is leaving from R dash. So that's why I am indicating it by dot. I am indicating it by dot. And the current which is entering into B dash. So B dash means how it will be B dash? See, the current is leaving from R dash and entering into some current, some 5 amperes current is flowing towards the Y phase, and 5 amperes current is flowing towards the B phase. So that's why towards Y phase which is going, I am indicating this Y, this color, that is 5 amperes, and this is towards B phase, this is 5 amperes. Now the current which is entering into B dash means current is entering into B dash, so that's why I am indicating this Y class. And here also the current is entering into Y dash, so that's why I am here also indicating by cross. And the current which is, the current is entering into Y dash means it has to leave from somewhere, that is Y phase only. It is entering from Y and leaving from entering from Y dash and leaving from Y, so that's why the leaving point I am taking is dot, and which will be extended like this, which is connected to Y phase. And by coming into this also, B dash current is entering into B dash and leaving from B. So that's why current entering point I am putting as cross and leaving point I am mentioning as dot. And I am extending this wire up to here to connect the supply, that is B. So we can able to observe here the current entering points indicated by cross and leaving points indicated by dot. So by seeing this, I can able to say as per the coming rule, what will happen whenever the current which is entering into the conductor, then what will happen? The magnetic field will be takes place in the clockwise direction, in this direction. And here also, for B dash and Y dash, the same in the clockwise direction. So, some magnetic field will be takes around this, and magnetic field will be takes around this, and takes around this in the clockwise direction. But the combined if you are taking, we are combined taking the magnetic field, then I can write like this. So, this will be in the clockwise direction. So, that's why I can mention like this. And while coming into this downward conductors, the current is leaving from Y and R dash and B. So that's why this will be leaving, means the magnetic field direction will be in the anti-clockwise direction. And here also magnetic field will take place, here also in three places magnetic field will be takes place, and that will be anti-clockwise direction. But combinedly, if I am taking combinedly, then I can indicate the magnetic field like this. But the total magnetic field is flowing towards this left side. Okay, so that if you are taking a permanent magnet, then how it will be? If you are taking, considering a permanent magnet, it is north pole, it is south pole. The magnetic field will be released from N pole and enters back to south pole. Means like this. It means the direction of magnetic field will be from south to north. Here also from south to north. Means current, the magnetic field is releasing from north pole and entering into south pole. So that's why here the magnetic field is releasing from this point. So that's why here I can mention as north pole. And the current is, the magnetic field is reaching to this point. So I am indicating by this south pole. So finally I can indicate here the magnetic field direction is, I am indicating by the arrow, that is like this. That is like this. This is in this direction. Okay. For the next instant, if I am taking another instant, how the magnetic field will be rotated, that thing we have to see. So that's why I am taking next instant. In first instant, it goes like this. And in the second instant, if I am taking this point, at this point, which one is maximum? B phase is maximum. B phase is maximum means it is, let us take maximum point I am taking 10 amperes, that is a negative peak, so that's why minus 10 amperes. Minus 10 amperes. And in the upper side, that is in positive side, in positive peak, what will be here? The Y phase and R phase is not maximum, but it is somewhat near to half of the value. So that's why I am considering here example, I take for all kinds of lines. And let us draw a same like this diagram again for the second step. If I am drawing this like this, and here also I have to draw the same things. Here R conductor, here R dash conductor, here Y conductor, here Y dash conductor, here V conductor, here V dash. So like this I will connect. And while coming into this same thing I have to draw here also. See now this R, R dash, Y dash, Y, B, B dash. So, if you have connected the three phase supply, the same supply you have connected, but the second, for the second instant we have seen here, for the second instant, which one is maximum? Here maximum peak point is that is in negative, but maximum current which is in the negative peak. So that's why the current has to be leave. Negative means the current will not be entered, current has to be leave, that is minus 10 amperes. It means here also minus 10 amperes. But while coming into the R phase and Y phase, what it will be from the R phase, the current is entering. Why? Because it is positive peak. So that's why from R phase, the current is entering, that is 5 amperes is entering, and here 5 amperes. And from Y phase also, we can able to see there in the waveform, that is also 5 amperes. Here also 5 amperes. It means it is also satisfying the case here. It means from R phase 5 amperes is coming and from Y phase also 5 amperes is coming towards the junction, that is this junction, and these two are combining adding and coming back to B. But that's why we have mentioned there minus 10 amperes. Why? Because Y phase is in negative. So while coming into this, we can able to see for this shader also. Let us see as we have seen previously here, that is from R phase, how much current is entering, that is 5 amperes. 5 amperes is entering, so that's why I am mentioning here, cross. And the current which has must be leave from R dash, why? Because the back to back connection will be there for R and R dash, because of that same term, these two connectors are belongs to the same term. So that's why current is entering from R, leaving from R dash. And again, we can able to see this R dash, Y dash, and B dash are connected to enter one point. So I can mention like this means the current which is leaving from R dash is 5 amperes. 5 amperes. And what about Y? From Y also, from Y phase also, the current is, from Y phase also, the current is 5 amperes is entering to Y. So that's why I have been mentioning here cross. And the current has to be leave from Y dash, so that's why I am putting a dot. It means the current will go like this, that is my plus 5 amperes. These two will be added and enter into B dash. Enter into B dash, that's why I am putting here cross, and the current will be leave from B, so that's why I am mentioning here B, that is minus 10 amperes. In this case, we have to see as per the coming rule, the current is entering into R, B dash and Y dash, means clockwise direction of magnetic field will be. So that's why the combined magnetic field I can mention like this. I can mention the combined magnetic field like this. And from Y dash, B and R dash, that will be current is leaving. So because of that, so that's why it will be in anticlockwise direction. So that's why in anticlockwise direction here, here, here. So that's why combined, if you are taking the combined magnetic field will be like this, I can mention. So it will be upper direction. Okay. So the magnetic field direction is like this now. Okay. Now the current leaving from a point means the magnetic field which is leaving from a point means this will be the north pole and this will be the south pole. So that's why here finally we can able to draw an arrow which is indicated the direction of the field, the direction of the magnetic field. It means in this instant, in the first instant, the magnetic field direction is towards this left side, and here in this case it is that side. So if you are seeing for each and every instant from this waveform, if you are drawing like this for each and every instant, the magnetic field will be, first case it will be like this, after that it is rotated like this, after in the next instant if you are drawing like this, it will be, after that it will rotate like this. It means the magnetic field is rotating in the induction mode. So that's why we can see that the magnetic field will be rotated in induction force, that's why we call it as rotating magnetic field. Okay, thank you.